So yesterday we were discussing about the methods of list. So continuation with that topic, I think we have discussed the pop method, okay? Now, next method is remove. Remove method of list. Now, as per the pop method, we know the index of that element which we want to remove. But consider a situation where index is not known to us. Then how to remove the element where we don't know about the index? In that particular situation, we use remove method. Okay? So please give a heading to your notebook. Remove method. Put the date also. Like I have a list, A equal to 11, 12, 13, 14, 12, 15, 16, 12, 17, 12. A dot remove 12. Now 12 is coming three times. So it will remove the first occurrence of 12. Check it. And remember the pop method which I explained yesterday. The element which was removed, it was printed. It was returned. It was displayed also. But here, check it out. The desired element which is to be removed is not displayed. Yani remove method, element ko return nahi karta. Am I clear to all? Now I try to remove the element which does not exist in the list. I try to remove the element which does not exist in the list. Python will raise an error. When you try to remove an element using the remove method which does not exist in the list, Python will indicate an error. Clear? The next method we have is clear method. Clear method. Now, what is the role of clear method? By name, it is very much clear. Complete list goes empty. All the elements of the list get cleared, gets removed, and list becomes empty. The list object exists. List object delete nahi ho gaya. Wo abhi bhi hai, sirf wo empty hai. Okay, like I say A dot clear. When you print A, all the elements are removed. Now A will behave like an empty list. Check it. Empty square brackets are there. Am I clear to all? Empty square bracket आएगी value कहाँ से है value तो है ही कोई नहीं this object list का नाम whenever you will display A it will create it will return empty list सिर्फ list empty हुई है पर वो exist कर रही है in empty form it is still there. One thing is clear, one thing is remove, one thing is pop. But the fourth thing is totally different. Delete. डीईएल, लिसन लिसन, डिलीट कोई फंक्शन नहीं है, डिलीट स्टेटमेंट है. व्हेन यू आर यूजिंग डीईएल टू डिलीट सम ऑब्जेक्ट, नो डाउट इट विल रिमूव द एलिमेंट ऑल्सो, बट इट विल रिमूव द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑल्सो. नो ऑब्जेक्ट विद दैट नेम विल फर्दर एग्जिस्ट. आई गिव एन एग्जाम्पल, x इक्वल टू 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. दिस इज अ लिस्ट. ये लिस्ट डिस्प्ले हो गई मेरी. मैंने कहा del x. I said del x. Now elements are removed plus the object is also removed. If you try to, please look at LCD. If you try to print x now, Python will raise an error because no object, no sequence, no structure exists with that name. पर क्लियर से ये नहीं था. When you used to use clear, the object exists only, the thing is it has become empty. It has become empty. Okay? Difference in clear and delete is clear. So clear will not delete the object. It will still exist. Only the elements are removed. But delete will remove elements as well as object. Clear is a function, delete is a statement. Online class, am I clear up till here? Chirag, Diya, Gursirat. All right. Moving to the next method, count. Statement. Next is count method. Count method. Count method means you are to count the occurrence of a particular element, that this value is occurring how many times, the frequency of some value, ki wo kitni baar occur ho rahi. I have a list x equal to 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 13, 17, 18, 19, 13. Okay, I say list name dot count bracket 13. I want to count the occurrence of 13. What will be the result? 4. Why 4? 13 is occurring in the list 4 times. Got it? One exception is there. पहले ये इंप्लीमेंट कर लो, देन आई टेल. शैल आई कंटिन्यू? इफ यू ट्राई टू काउंट द अकरेंस ऑफ एनी वैल्यू विच डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट, Python will return 0 by default. Zero hi aayega. You are trying to count the occurrence of one such value which does not exist in the list. So Python will display 0 by default. Please note down this point in the count function. If we try to count any element which does not exist in the list, if we try to count the occurrence of any element which does not occur, which does not exist in the list. Python will display 0 by default. Python will display 0 by default. Now, next method we are proceeding is reverse. Reverse method of list. Now, by reverse, we mean the list is printed in reverse order. The list gets printed in reverse order. Okay? Suppose I have a list x to le lete hain, x dot reverse. Check it. Compare this blue color reverse list with the original list. I take one more example. A equal to B comma C comma D comma E. I say A dot reverse. Check it. B C D E reverse is E D C D. Bracket में am I clear to all? Now next method is sort method. Okay, what according to you is the general meaning of sort? Raise your hand. Don't give the mass answering. Only raise your hand. What do you mean by the word sort? Arrange in terms of what? Yes. To arrange the elements in increasing or decreasing order. The default ordering is increasing. The default ordering is increasing. Like suppose I have a list A, 3, 4, 1, 5, 2, 6. I say A dot sort. And I print A. Check it out. Noticed. Now in this particular method, carefully observe one important point. While performing the sort function, it does not create any new list. Usne sorting karke ek nayi list tayar nahi kar di. Rather, it is working on original. It is working on original, on the same list only. It has not generated any new list. Rather, it is on the same very list. Dekho, yahan pe koi nayi list nahi generate ho gayi. Theek hai? Clear hai? Now, this was the sorting in increasing order. What about if we want to sort in decreasing order? For that, you have to pass one parameter inside the sort function, reverse equal to true. Check it. Reverse equal to true. Am I clear? So this command will always display your list in decreasing order. The command which I have shaded. Now consider some small functions. Min function. I say min A. Min function will display the minimum value from the list. So what it will display? One. Then I say max. Max will display the maximum value from the list. Max function and pass the list name as parameter inside the max function. Then sum function. Sum function will automatically sum up all the values, all the elements of the list. Okay? 6 plus 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1 is 21. Am I clear to all?
Yes.
Now, one was sort function. Another is coming sorted function. Sort function, I told you, it will not generate any new list. Rather, it works on the given list only. Sorted function, no doubt, it will also sort in increasing or decreasing order, but it will generate a new list in sorted order. आपने क्या करना है, जो आपकी original list है वो sorted function के अंदर as a parameter pass कर देनी. Sorted function उसके ऊपर work करेगा, work out करके list को sort करेगा और एक नई list generate कर देगा. And the new list which will get generated will be in sorted order. What I mean by this is, I say A equal to 4, 5, 1, 2, 3. Right? Am I clear? Now I say A dot B equal to sorted bracket A. Sorted function ke andar, you pass the list name as a parameter, it will sort it, it will work on it and assign the list to the new variable B. So jo B print hoga, wo sorted print hoga. सॉर्ट मेथड में नई लिस्ट क्रिएट नहीं होती, उसी लिस्ट को सॉर्ट करके डिस्प्ले करवा देता. ये देखो, आप दिस वाज योर ओरिजिनल लिस्ट, ओरिजिनल लिस्ट को सॉर्टेड के अंदर एज अ पैरामीटर पास कर दिया, इसने उसके ऊपर वर्क किया, उसको सॉर्ट कर दिया, सॉर्ट करके एक नई लिस्ट क्रिएट कर दी बी नाम की. जब बी को प्रिंट कराया तो सॉर्टेड लिस्ट प्रिंट हुई, पर जब ए को प्रिंट कराया इट प्रिंट एज इट इज एज इट वॉज ओरिजिनल. मतलब आई क्लियर टू ऑल? सेम इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डिक्रीजिंग. सी इक्वल टू सॉर्टेड bracket A, comma, reverse equal to true. When you want to display the list in sort decreasing order using the sorted function. Now, I have a question. Which list will be sorted, C or A? Which list will be in the sorted form?
C.
C. Decreasing order. What if I print A? The normal list. That was original. Am I totally clear to everyone, online and offline? So with this, we end up all the functions of list. Okay? Total, there are 16 functions and we have ended up the all. Clear? Now write one question. Write a program. Come on the very new page. Write a program to initialize a list and display a new list such that if element is even, its twice should get printed. If element is odd, its thrice should get printed. My concept is, if element of list is even, its twice should get printed. If element of list is odd, its thrice should get printed. Clear? So we shall be discussing it in the next class.